Hi, this is Rich. Welcome to my blog. In my last video, I started to talk about false teachings. Just the whole concept of false teachings. We hear that there's a lot of false teachings on Earth right now to keep us kind of dumbed down and stupid and ignorant.
Yeah.
So one of the teachings I've come across and I got pretty interested in is the I am. The I am that I am. I mean, what the hell does that mean? I am that I am. Huh? We hear the turn of phrase here and there and everywhere. But anyway, if you're into be here now and be the conscious awareness that you are or that I am, that makes sense. I am. But it occurred to me that what if that's a false teaching? And it occurred to me because when I practice just being, like, be focused. Instead of wanting to feel secure, be secure. It's like a command. It's like a hypnotic command, like an affirmation. But it's not something you're doing. It's not something you have. Instead of, it's like be productive. As opposed to I am productive. The I am that I am. I'm a little suspicious of the words and phrases of I am relative to be. Be clear. I am clear. As in speaking clearly. When you practice whatever you're practicing, if you get caught up in the philosophy of it, if you become freer and more able and experience changes for the better, then that would be a good teaching, right? A false teaching would get you engaged and kind of hooked on it and be more like an addictive, never really satisfied, want more, want more, want more sort of thing. So when I imagine I am disciplined. I'm disciplined. Relative to be disciplined. Well, here's the difference to me and why I believe that the I am thing is a false teaching. I'm sure there's a lot of people going to argue with me on this, but that's okay. When we say I am this or I am that, you know, I am happy, I am doing good, I am feeling great, I am, I am, I am. We're calling forth the concept of I, and the I is very well connected with the ego self, the idea of who I am. I am rich. I'm a nice guy. Sometimes. I am frustrated sometimes. But when normally in everyday life, when you or me or I talk about myself, I'm talking about the identity self. In other words, the ego self that I am. So even though you may intend to be saying, I am, meaning the true consciousness that you are, you're in fact saying the words, I am, and this will invoke, though there's the power in words are very powerful. The words embed the idea and the concept. So when I say, I am invoking the idea of me, the self that I am. And that's ego. But if you're trying to get to the same place and you say, I am confident, you're invoking the ego aspect of self, and you can trigger the thoughts and thinking, and the next thing is, am I really? And you question yourself, and you might have little doubts, or, you know, background noise and thought and thing. I'm doing great. Yeah, you're sure you are. You know, that sort of, well, as a practice, as I experience the phenomena of personal development techniques for and strategies for betterment, and I use this I am thing, I am getting this I am stuff going, and it keeps me engaged with the ego self. But if I go straight to be confident, okay, and just I can be it. You know, I might be able to be it, whatever it is, be confident, be strong, be understandable, be funny, be productive, be courageous. As soon as I say that, I can sort of, I get the feeling of it, just, and it might be just a micro sense of it before it fades, or I might be able to feel it and experience that beingness for longer periods of time. And that's the whole idea. You want to be, practice being right now, be whatever it is, with the idea of getting better and better at it. And you're literally rewiring your brain, your neural network, your reticular activating system, when you just go, you know, be confident, be strong-willed, be clear, be easygoing, be relaxed, be cool. It's just, and you do not invoke the mind, you do not invoke the ego self. Consciousness and the awareness that you are does not invoke the ego, because it's not saying the words I am. So I'm just, it just occurred to me today, is that a false teaching, this whole I am thing? I'm not saying everybody doing it on purpose, you know, being cleverly false to, you know, compromise the consciousness and the growth of humanity. I'm just saying, what if that's another false teaching? What are your thoughts? I am confident that I am right. Or be confident. Be right. Okay. All right. Feel it. Yeah, be right. Feel it. Yeah, it feels good. When you do that, when you practice that, you're literally kicking in serotonin in your body. That's one of your feel-good chemicals. Kicking a little bit, kicking a lot. Practice. Rewire your particular activating system. Anyway, just wanted to share that thought with you. Thank you for watching my stuff. Share your comments. I want to hear your philosophy about all this stuff. And do you have some favorite law of attraction teachers? You know, our personal development teachers that, you know, practice the create your own reality, manifest your dreams and all that stuff. Different books, videos, teachers. Share in a comment below, because I'm on the snoop. I am looking for this stuff. Now, when I say I am looking, we're talking about the egoic self that I identify in consciousness with, this identity of myself. And just because I have an ego here doesn't mean it's good or bad or indifferent. It's just the ego self. Then we can judge it with another aspect of our ego self. But so that's what I am doing. I am looking for new teachings and learning about this. Be here now stuff, manifest your own reality and all that stuff. So if you find this stuff particularly interesting, the whole manifest your own reality, law of attraction sort of thing, while using be here now, quiet mind, visualization, intention, all that stuff. Go over to richwest.net and see what you can see about the new Law of Attraction Bootcamp Forum. I've got it's free. Mm-hmm. Check it out. Okay. Talk to you later.